I now request the distinguished delegate of Sri Lanka.
Madam President, ladies and gentlemen, Sri Lanka congratulates you, Madam President, on your election to this high office. Last year, in September, we adopted the 2030 Agenda for Sustainable Development, which has the potential to transform the lives of billions of people on Earth. The Sustainable Development Agenda we adopted was no doubt a visionary plan of action that would determine the path of progress of humanity and indeed a universal push to transform our world for the good. We have now reached the implementation stage of the Sustainable Development Goals. Madam President, I am extremely pleased to share with you the information that we are in the process of tabling in Parliament a comprehensive National Sustainable Development Act in conformity with the Sustainable Development Goals. The objective of this new act is to facilitate the formulation of a national policy and strategy on sustainable development and provide the necessary legal and institutional framework for developing and implementing it. The act will mandate ministries, provincial councils, local governments, and all public sector agencies to prepare sustainable development strategies and carry out audits and provide annual progress reports based on a set of sustainable development standards, guidelines, and indicators. Madam President, achieving sustainable development goals is the only way to put an end to poverty. Poverty is presently a serious challenge throughout the world. We have made significant progress in poverty eradication by achieving the target of reducing poverty at the national level since 2008. We have launched various programs such as colonization schemes during post-independence period and more recently Janasavya and Samruddhi for the purpose of extending a helping hand to millions of poor people. Madam President, we have taken effective steps to strengthen democracy, rule of law and good governance in our country. We want to create a better country for our people. To achieve these, we need the assistance of the international community. Different countries have their own unique authentic thinking. We too have such authentic thinkings and visions. We want to create a country in which our people can live as better humans. For a better tomorrow, we seek assistance and blessings of you all for this task. I wish to take this opportunity to express appreciation about the services rendered by the outgoing UN Secretary General Ban Ki-moon. He provided an excellent service to the entire world. Thank you.